So after finding yc, we will calculate yp. Yp is given by 1 upon fd into x. We used to write x, but in this case our x is replaced by z. So our fd is nothing but d minus 2. In a simplified form, it is d minus 2 into d square plus 1, and z is e raised to 2z plus e raised to minus 3z. I am multiplying this term inside the bracket. I will get 1 upon d minus 2 into d square plus 1 into e raised to 2z plus 1 upon d minus 2 into d square plus 1 into e raised to minus 3z. So as you can see, these two terms are of the form 1 upon fd into e raised to ax. So it is of the form of type 1. Instead of x, here we have z. So in this we replace d by a. So similarly here also we are going to replace d by a. So in this case d will be replaced by a. Here a is 2. So we can replace d equal to 2 in this case, but we cannot replace for this term because this term is creating a problem. So we will keep 1 upon d minus 2 as it is, and we will replace here d equal to 2. So d square will be 2 square, which is 4 plus 1, which is 5. So 1 upon 5 because of this term into e raised to 2z plus, here we are going to substitute d equal to a. Here a is minus 3. So we substitute minus 3 here, so we get minus 5, and minus 3 the square is, minus 3 square is 9 plus 1. So 10 into minus 5 is nothing but minus 1 upon 50. So it is minus 1 upon 50 and e raised to minus 3z. Here we have d minus 2 term, and this term is creating problem. So we know that if we have d plus a term and e raised to ax, then its solution is given by x raised to r upon r factorial into e raised to ax. So this is the solution for this part. In our case, r is 1 and a is 2. So for this term, it can be written as 1 upon 5 e raised to 2z into, here we have x raised to r. In this case, our x is replaced by z. So z raised to r, r is 1 upon r factorial, r is 1 minus this term, which is 1 upon 50 e raised to minus 3z. So this is our yp. So yp is z upon 5 into e raised to 2z minus 1 upon 50 e raised to minus 3z. So the final solution will be y equal to yc plus yp. Our yc is c1 e raised to 2 times z. Mind my words, here we have made one mistake. Here we have e raised to 2z. Here we have z. In this equation, in every equation in higher order differential equation with variable coefficient, we replace x by z. So here it should be e raised to 2z. E raised to 0z and cos of z and sine of z. Okay, it will not be x because here we have substituted z equal to log of x, and here it is the variable in terms of z and not in terms of x. So our yc and yp will also be in terms of z. So ec1 e raised to 2z plus c2 cos z plus c3 sin z plus z by 5 into e raised to 2z minus 1 upon 50 e raised to minus 3z, where z is log of x. Okay, so this is the final solution, and this is how we solve the problem on higher order differential equation with variable coefficients. More such problems we will see in our next video, so stay tuned for our future lectures.